Should we take a couple questions?
Both in Cutter and the thirst for learning, do you think that if we had this kind of level of wealth that Americans would still have a thirst for learning? Because I feel like that's something that's missing from our society.
There's never been a society more wealthy. And I think there's also never been a society, a generation less curious. And I think that we have been consumed, like we used to make things. Like I remember growing up, Coca had a slogan that said quality was job one. And now we make nothing, but we give you more of the bad shit we make. If you complain about something, they'll give you, like, I once complained about Delta Airlines. They go, we'll give you a free trip on the fucking airlines. Like, you used to be able to complain about, remember, Domino's used to say 30 minutes or it's free. And there used to be a level of pride and a commitment to what we did. And I think that now we're just, like, even, I remember my mother used to say, and I knew that you had to work twice as hard to get half as far. So they set a guideline for you that you understood. And even though you felt like it was going to be hard, at least they told you the rules. And I think that now, and that's irrespective of culture or what kind of ideology you espouse to, I think that we don't tell people what's expected of them. I remember terrorists are attacking the country, but go shopping or they'll win. I mean, that was really what we heard, go shopping or they'll win. There has to be a place where you're not just exceptional because of where your mother and father had a baby. You're exceptional because of what you invest and what you strive for. And there used to be, when I, watching the Olympics, and this is the first time I'd seen the Olympics, and this is the first thought I had. First, when we were rocking all these countries out, it was like, you know, going to a kid's graduation and you, man, get through all these countries so I can hear my kid. But all those countries invested in education, a great deal of those countries. And many of them had a healthcare system that was superior to ours. And that they invent, like Germany, Japan, they fought world wars, they wanted to be world powers. They lost those wars. Then they became economic and educational powers, and they are equal in those two endeavors. And I think that we can literally learn something. I'm sad that we haven't. And I know it's weird to hear high school dropout talking about education. I don't know if I'm going to do that.
So do you feel like it exploits you to something that you exposed yourself, or have you feel like someone's going to take something, a quote from the book, and misquote you?
Sure.
Mr. Sure.
But I think I wouldn't have written a book that I wasn't prepared for people to do.
Well, that's what's very curious. Were you worried about that?
I haven't been worried about anything like that. I mean, you literally would. It's funny because I hear beautiful women go, they don't like me because I'm
pretty.
I hear beautiful women will say why they don't get dates, and they'll give you the reason according to the estimation why that happens. You can never explain somebody's definition. Whatever. Somebody will say, or he's stuck, or he's this, or he's that. I'll always be that to that person, and I'm comfortable with whatever definition people have. If they've made a story up for themselves about me, and I have to be, mature enough to accept the fact that that's the way they're always going to see me. But I am not afraid to lose, and I'm not afraid to win, and I'm not afraid to be a hero, and I'm not afraid to be a villain. I think that it's a wonderful thing when the sound of your own voice can comfort you. So even when I'm scared, it's me I listen to. I know that sounds arrogant, but I'm not really afraid of somebody's assessment. Except me, baby. Only me.
Try to like two more questions.
Sure.
What advice could you give to the youth of America?
I think the dude. You don't have to know what you will do, just know what you want. At a certain point, you have to know what it is at your core you are. And that can't come from your parents, or your teachers, or your coaches. At a certain point, there has to be something in you that you listen to, and that you trust. and you trust, because no matter where you go, you'll always be with me. And you have to be enough in tune with yourself enough that the sound of your voice comforts you. And you can be your own hero. And I think too many times we've given that power to somebody else to make us feel better or to give us a way. You will decide what you do. Or you won't. And that's kind of how I feel.